as men say. Only fools rush in, but I can't help falling in love with you. Shall I stay? Would it be a sin if I can't help falling in love with you? Like a river flows surely to the sea, darling, so it goes. Some things are meant to be. Take my hand, take my whole life too, for I can't help falling in love with you. I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? And they're really saying, I love you. I hear babies cry, and I watch them grow. They'll learn much more than I'll ever know. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Here comes the sun, doo-doo-doo-doo. Here comes the sun, I say, it's all right. Little darling, it's been a long, cold, lonely winter. Little darling, it feels like years since it's been here. Here comes the sun, doo-doo-doo-doo. Here comes the sun, and I say, it's all right. It's all right.
On behalf of Casey and Tori, I want to welcome each and every one of you here to Holy Name Catholic Church. We gather today in this church for a very special reason. We gather to witness the love that the Lord has blessed this couple with. We will witness the exchange of their vows and exchange of rings and watch them become husband and wife before our eyes today. Let us pray. Casey and Tori, the church shares your joy and warmly welcomes you together with your family and friends as today, in the presence of God our Father, you establish between yourself a lifelong partnership. May the Lord hear you on this, your joyful day. May he send you help from heaven and protect you. May he grant you your heart's desire and fulfill every one of your prayers. We ask this in the name of Jesus, our Lord. Amen. I invite you now to please be seated as we listen to the Word of God. Not y'all.
A reading from the book of Genesis, chapter 2, verse 18 to 24. The Lord God said, "It is not good for the man to be alone. I will make a suitable partner for him." So the Lord God formed out of the ground various animals and various birds of the air, and he brought them to the man to see what he would call them. Whatever the man called each of them would be its name. The man gave the names of all the cattle, all the birds in the air, and all the wild animals, but none proved to be suitable for the partner of the man. So the Lord God cast a deep sleep on the man, and while he was asleep, he took out one of his ribs and closed up its place with flesh. The Lord God then built up into a woman the rib that he had taken from the man. When he brought her to the man said, "This one at last is bone of my bone and flesh of my flesh. This one should be called woman, for out of her man this has been taken. This is why a man leaves his father and mother and clings to his wife, and the two of them become one body." The word of the Lord.
Your response is, "I will bless the Lord at all times." I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall be ever in my mouth. Let my soul glory in the Lord. The lowly will hear me and be glad. I will bless the Lord at all times. Glorify the Lord with me. Let us together extol his name. I sought the Lord and he answered me and delivered me from all my fears. I will bless the Lord at all times. Look to him that you may be radiant with joy, and your faces may not blush with shame. When the poor one called out, the Lord heard, and from all his distress he saved him. I will bless the Lord at all times. The angel of the Lord encamps around those who fear him and delivers them. Taste and see how good the Lord is. Blessed the man who takes refuge in him. I will bless the Lord at all times.
The second reading, a reading from the letter of Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, I, a prisoner of the Lord, urge you to live in manner worthy of the call you have received, with all humility and gentleness, with patience, bearing from one another through love, striving to preserve the unity of the Spirit, through the bond of peace, one body and one spirit. As you were also called to the one hope of your call, one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of all, who is over all and through all and in all, the word of the Lord.
And the Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Jesus said, "From the beginning of creation, God made them male and female. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore, what God has joined together, no human being must separate." The Gospel of the Lord. You may be seated.
As I welcomed you here to this church, I said we gather in God's house for a special reason. We gather to witness the love that the Lord has blessed this couple with. I'm Father Tony, and I'm from Owensboro originally, but live in Hardingsburg currently. And I met Casey and Tori about 10 years ago. And it's an honor for me to be here today to witness their marriage and to be part of this wonderful, beautiful day. So I've been thinking about what I would like to say to this couple, because I want it to be as special to them as they are to all of us. And I had a dream the other night that I want to share with you. I don't always share my dreams with people, but I want to share this dream with you. And the dream takes place about 50 years from today, and it's after Casey and Tori's 50th wedding anniversary. And there had a big celebration, celebrating 50 years of marriage. They had their children, their grandchildren, their family with them. And everybody had left the house, and they were out on the front porch swinging. And Tori said, "You know, honey, I used to love it when you would hold my hand." And so he reached over and he held her hand, and big smile came over her face, and he thought, "I did good, you know." And so he swung back and forth a little bit more, and she said, "Honey, I used to love it when you would whisper sweet nothing in my ears." And so he kind of sat there for a second because he had to think of what to say. And finally he thought of something to say, and again, this big smile came over her face, and he thought, "I did good, you know." They'd swing back and forth a little bit more, and she said, "Honey, I used to love it when you'd nibble on my ear." Well, he got up from the swing and headed inside. And she said, "Oh, honey, what, did I say something wrong? What's wrong?" And he said, "I'm going to go put my teeth in." So, 50 years from today, how do we get to that? How do we get to 50 years? As we heard in Scripture, you are two, but now you will become one. And as any married couple knows, it doesn't happen magically. It happens with a lot of work, hard work, commitment, a lot of communication, a lot of give and take, a lot of sacrifice to get to that 50th wedding anniversary. And so today you gather in this church before your family and your friends to begin that process of living 50 years as husband and wife, and hopefully even longer than that. As I think about life, I think about God giving us gifts. And God gives us a lot of gifts throughout life. He gives us the gift of life, the gift of faith. And today, God is going to give to each of you a very special gift, and that's each other. So, Tori, today God gives you the precious gift of Casey, and Casey, today God gives you the precious gift of Tori. And with any gift that God gives to you, there's three things that are required. You have to take care of that gift, you have to use that gift, and then you have to share that gift. Because any gift that God gives us is not given to us solely for our own purpose, but it's given to us so that we can share it with other people. So today, my prayer for you is very simply that the love that the Lord has blessed you with to this day, that He will continue to bless that love many times over. He will allow you to grow old in the company of your family and friends, and at the end of a long life, He will give you the greatest gift of all, eternal life with Him in heaven. So with that being said, we now allow these two very special people, Casey and Tori, to begin their life as husband and wife. Turn in place. Dearly beloved, you've come together into the house of the church so that in the presence of the church minister and the community, your intention to enter into marriage may be strengthened by the Lord with a sacred seal. Christ abundantly blesses the love that binds you. Through a special sacrament, He enriches and strengthens those He has already consecrated by holy baptism, that they may be faithful to each other forever and assume all the responsibilities of married life. And so in the presence of the church, I ask that you state your intentions. Casey and Tori, have you come here to enter into marriage without force, freely, and wholeheartedly? Are you prepared as you follow the path of marriage to love and honor each other for as long as you both shall live? Are you prepared to accept children lovingly from God and to bring them up according to the law of Christ and the church? Amen. Since it is your intention to enter the covenant of holy matrimony, I ask that you join your hands and declare your consent before God, your family, and this church. I, Casey, take you, Tori, to be my wife. I promise to be faithful to you in good times and in bad. In sickness and in health, to love you and to honor you all the days of my life. I, Tori, take you, Casey, to be my husband. I promise to be faithful to you in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health. To love you and to honor you all the days of my life. May the Lord in His kindness strengthen the consent you have declared before the church and graciously bring to fulfillment His blessings within you. What God has joined together, let no one put asunder. And now the rings, please. May the Lord bless these rings which you will give to each other as a sign of love and fidelity. Tori, receive this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Casey, receive this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Light the candle. Okay, go.
Miles, I had it all planned. Drove all day to ask your dad for your hand. I wrote it all out, I knew what I'd say. My heart, it was racing, and my hands started to shake. But I took a deep breath and I said, I promise to love her with all that I have. I'll put nothing above her, and I won't turn my back. She's my everything, she's all I'll ever need, and she loves me at my worst. Sir, I give you my word, I promise to love her. The music plays and I'm all a mess as I watch you walking towards me in that pretty white dress. Do you take this woman to be your wife, to have and to hold for the rest of your life? Well, I took a deep breath and I said, I promise to love her with all that I have. I'll put nothing above her, and I won't turn my back. She's my everything, she's all I'll ever need, and she loves me at my worst. I'm giving my word, I promise to love her and keep her, want her and need her, make her my whole world. And when that day comes, I'll come undone when the doctor brings in that little girl. I promise to love her with all that I have. I put nothing above her, and I won't turn my back. She'll be my everything, all I'll ever need, my little angel on earth. Lord, I give you my word, I promise to love her, I give you my word, I promise to love her.
And now we have a very special blessing that we pray over this newly married couple. I invite the family and friends of Casey and Tori to pray along with me in silence as I pray this prayer aloud. O God, who by your mighty power created all things out of nothing, and when you had set in place the beginnings of the universe, form man and woman in your own image, making the woman an inseparable helpmate to the man, that they may no longer be two but one flesh, and taught that what you were pleased to make one must never be divided. Look now with favor on these your servants, Casey and Tori, joined together in marriage, who ask to be strengthened by your blessing. Send down on them the grace of the Holy Spirit and pour your love into their hearts, that they may remain faithful in the marriage covenant. May the grace of love and peace abide in your daughter, Tori, and let her always follow the example of those holy women whose praises are sung in the sacred scriptures. May her husband, Casey, entrust his heart to her so that acknowledging her as his equal and his joint heir to the life of grace, he may show her due honor and cherish her always with the love that Christ has for the church. And grant that reaching at last together the fullness of years for which they hope, they may come to the life of the blessed in the kingdom of heaven. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. I invite you to please stand. We bring all of our prayers into one as we pray the prayer that our Savior has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And now it's my honor and privilege to be the first to introduce to you and to the Commonwealth of Kentucky, Mr. and Mrs. Casey Todd. Well, hello.
Like a fool, I went and stayed too long. Now I'm wondering if your love's still strong. Ooh, baby, here I am, signed, sealed, delivered, I'm yours. Then that time I went and said goodbye. Now I'm back and not ashamed to cry. Ooh, baby, here I am, signed, sealed, delivered, I'm yours. Here I am, baby, signed, sealed, delivered, I'm yours. Here I am, baby, signed, sealed, delivered, I'm yours. Seen a lot of things in this old world. When I touch them, they mean nothing, girl. Ooh, baby, here I am, signed, sealed, delivered, I'm yours. Really, baby, you set my soul on fire. That's why I know you're my heart's only desire. Ooh, baby, here I am, signed, sealed, delivered, I'm yours. Here I am, baby, signed, sealed, delivered, I'm yours. Here I am, baby, signed, sealed, delivered, I'm yours.